A lot of my work is on the grand sport in the state of East Anglia, and the last thing the keeper wants is 20 of these near his pheasant pen. So I use a lot of light-coloured ferrets, so I can see them on top of the ground. Why do I need to see them? Because these animals work a lot on top of the ground as they do underneath the ground. So I'm looking at ferreting now slightly differently than I did 30 years ago. Then, that was a tweedy traditional pastime, but tradition ain't going to catch a rabbit for you. That's what you've got to do. So for me now, ferreting is like modern day football. Now modern day football is a squad game. You've got a long and arduous season. When you're working in an environment gained upon the results, and if you don't get the right results, you ain't going to get anything to take home at the end of the day. So that's going to make your brain focus into getting your animals right. Because no matter who you are, who you think you are, how many times you go ferreting, you're only as good as those ferrets in that box. So what we've got to do is show people how they can get the best out of these little creatures. So we're going to start with the vehicles that here at Western Park are going to take us in our little world of being a ferreter. You have two choices. No matter what colour, bright blue, pink, purple, you've got two choices. A male ferret and a female ferret. Now we have little names for these in our world. The male ferret we call a hop or a dog. The female ferret we call a Jill or a bitch. Now these vehicles are built differently. You've got a male ferret, a hog. He has got a very big fuselage there. On a big chassis, some say wrongly, if I hold him up, he's got a gap there for the wind and the rain to come through. So it's like a 70s Land Rover. He's a chugger, he's a four-wheel drive. We look at this creature. This creature is completely different. Aesthetically pleasing, streamlined and aerodynamically designed, minuscule fuselage, lightweight chassis. She's built for speed. The Jill will flow through a warren like Will-O-The-Wisp. So for me, the Jill ferret is the Ferrari, the posh of the ferret world.